Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's look at how to use alignment guides in Pages, Numbers, and Keynote. So you have created a new document in Pages, and to make things easier for this demo, I'm going to go to Document and turn off the document body so that doesn't get in the way. But this all works even with the document body there. Now I'm going to create shape and create just a square. Now, as I drag this around the screen, these alignment guides appear there for the center, so I can align this very easily to the center. It kind of snaps into place as I drag through it. I can also have the edges go to the center, or the edges to the edge of the page, or the center to the edge, any way I want to do it. I get the top, I get the center vertically like that. I can lock it right to the very center of the page by locking both vertical and horizontal. I'm just dragging around and these yellow lines are appearing. If you don't see them, check in Pages Preferences under Rulers and make sure you have alignment guides turned on. Now they're more for this just locking to the page itself. I'm going to create another shape here and I can lock this shape to the other one. So you can see here that it's locking both the top, the bottom, and also the center there because these shapes are the same size. I can do it vertically here like that. If I were to adjust the shape of the size of this shape, then it makes it more clear that I can lock center to center, I can lock bottom to bottom, I can lock bottom to center. Any of these alignment guides in any of the directions, I can kind of lock things to it. So it's very easy. This not only works for moving, but also for resizing. So as I resize this, you can see it locks there. So I can very easily lock the top and the bottom, get it to be the same height even if it's a different width. I can go down here and if I wanted to get this to be the same size I can easily lock it like that, then bring it back over here and lock it in place. So it's very easy to resize objects so that they're the same size as other objects, or at least the same width or the same height. So let me show you how you can use this to create a really quick perfectly laid out set of blocks. So I can lock these two top to bottom like that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to, if I select this and I use the down arrow key, it moves down one pixel basically. I'm going to move it back up. I'm going to hold the shift and down arrow key and it moves it a greater distance. I think it's approximately 10 pixels. So I create a nice little gap there. Now I can create another shape and I can lock it here and I'm going to shift and right arrow to move it the same distance apart. And now I'm going to drag this shape here so it locks to the bottom there. So these could be three photos here and you see how I very easily created perfect symmetry between these. All the edges are all nicely locked together. And I can continue to do that. I'm going to option drag here to duplicate that item and then drop it there and then do the same thing down here. And then what I'm going to do is, well, let's go and I'm going to make this exactly the size of two of these with the gap. So I'm going to put this here at the bottom, shift and right arrow to give it the same spacing, shift and right arrow for that, get the same spacing, and then drag this across like that. So you can see it's very easy and quick to create these shapes like this. I can continue to do it like that, shift and down arrow, and then I want to create a option drag this, put this in this place there, and now it's as simple as that. Very easy. These are now perfectly spaced, perfect margins between everything, and everything's really even. So these could be photos, or I could actually just drag and drop photos into these to create a nice photo collage. It's perfectly aligned in really no time flat at all. I don't have to mess around with rulers. The rulers are there, and I can certainly see what I'm doing a little clearer with the rulers, but I don't even need to use those to have these be perfectly spaced. I can also select, drag and select all of these, group them together now. So I'll do arrange group right like that, and then now I can drag them as one group here. So I can center the entire thing on the page if I wish, and there's the page center. So now I can actually align other things to this. So you can continue to group and ungroup things and align them to create exactly the effects that you want. Search works the same in Numbers and Keynote. You can do the same thing here. I'm doing it in Keynote and creating exactly the same type of deal. And it works basically the same way. get a little bit more feedback in Keynote since you're actually doing these layouts a little more commonly, and you can see how it's actually giving you some information there. Also, the preferences give you a little more detail here under rulers in Keynote. You get four different options instead of just two. And it, like with pages, you can also change the color of these.